Good morning, student. After completion of chapter 1st of physics class 9, today I am going to start chapter 2nd of physics, which is force and law of motion. In our daily life, we observe many things on which some force is applied and the object starts to move. And some force brings an object to rest. Some force makes some object become faster and some object slower. Sometimes direction of the object changes and sometimes the shape and size of the object changes. All these changes, either from rest to motion, motion to rest, direction, shape or size, all needs effort. That effort which is applied on the object is known as force. You are seeing here, if there is an object which is at rest, a force applied on it, it starts to move. In second case, an object is moving, then opposite force applied on the object, it comes to rest. So this is force. So we can easily define force. This means, what is force? Force is an external effect which changes an object from rest to motion or motion to rest or tends to do so. This means, if an object comes in motion, this is due to force. If an object stops, which was earlier moving, that is due to force. And when we apply force on the wall, suppose that wall is not moving, but I am trying to move the wall, this is also known as force. So tends to move. This means force either brings an object from rest to motion, or motion to rest, or try to do so. So this is force. This means force is an external effort, external effect. Now, in class 9, type of force. There are two types of force. First is balanced force and second is unbalanced force. If the resultant force acting on an object is zero, then the forces are known as balanced force. You are seeing here an object on which a force F1 is acting in forward direction. On the same object, a force F2 is acting in opposite direction and object does not move. This means effect of this force, both the forces cancel each other. That's why resultant will be 0. F1 plus F2 equal to 0. Never forget, here F2 is in opposite directions, so there will be minus. This means F1 minus F2. That is equal to plus minus minus. So resultant is 0. There may be more than two forces. A force in this direction, another force opposite directions, a force from up to down and down to up. So maybe F1 plus F2 plus F3 plus F4, total result, that is 0. This means this object is under the effect of a balanced force. Similar thing happened here for unbalanced. If the resultant force acting on an object is not 0, an object is under the effect of F1 force, and a force F2 is also acting on the object, but opposite direction, but the value magnitude of the both the forces are different. F1 greater than F2, so F1 plus F2 not equal to 0. The object will move in the direction of F1. In such condition, we can say sum of the forces is not equal to 0. This means is obstructed under the effect of unbalanced force. This means under the effect of balanced force, there is no chance to move an object. Or if any object is moving with uniform motion, there is no chance to bring the object at rest. But under the effect of unbalanced force, any object may come from rest to motion or motion to rest. A speed may be increased, speed may be decreased. So unbalanced force is more effective in our daily life. So this is two type of the forces, balanced and unbalanced. Thanks, that's all.